Today, we'll learn how to make an Instagram-style filter, giving your photos a dark, moody effect. If you'd like to follow along with me today, I've left a download link for the photo I'll be using in the video description. I've also included a download link for another image you can use to practice all the techniques we'll learn about. To make our moody effect, the first thing we're going to do is apply a channel mixer. To do this, come to the Adjustment Studio, and then select Channel Mixer. With the Channel Mixer adjustment, we can modify the colors of the red, green, and blue color channels of our photo. When we're working on the red channel, you can see that our red slider is set to 100%. If we come to the green channel, the green slider is set to 100%. And, as you might expect, if we come to the blue channel, then our blue slider is set to 100%. Having each one of these sliders set to 100% means the red, green, and blue color channels of our photo will appear as normal. So far, the channel mixer has done nothing to change our image. However, we're going to use the blue channel to modify the blues in our photo. First, take the blue slider down to 0%. Now the blues have become yellow. But now we'll add green to the blues of our photo by bringing the green slider up to 100%. Now the blues in our image have become cyan. The next thing we're going to work on is the woman's skin tones. To do this, apply a selective color adjustment. Then, we're going to set this adjustment to affect the neutral tones of our image in order to affect her skin color. You can play around here to see what you think looks good, but I'm going to remove some cyan from her skin and add a little bit of magenta and yellow. You can see that this adjustment is really helping to improve the colors of her skin. Next, we're going to apply an HSL adjustment. With our HSL adjustment, we'll set the color range to affect the cyans of our image. Then, we'll decrease the saturation to around -35%, giving our photo a nice muted appearance. For this photo, I think her hat is standing out a little too much, so I'll change the color range to reds, and then lower the saturation to around -20%. Let's see a before and after of our HSL adjustment layer. I know we've been using a lot of different adjustment layers in this tutorial, and if you're feeling a little overwhelmed by all of them, I recommend you check out the Adjustment Layers chapter of our Beginner's Guide to Affinity Photo for iPad. It covers each adjustment layer in detail, so you won't have to wonder how any of them work. I'll leave a link to the guide in the video description. For the next part of the effect, we're going to apply a curves adjustment layer. From the context toolbar, press on the spline option. Now we can affect the lighting of our photo. We're going to bring up the shadows in our image and then take down the highlights. This gives our photo less contrast, making it look more muted. Then we'll change to the blue channel and open the spline again. Once more, we'll raise the shadows node and lower the highlights node. This time though, doing this is adding blues to our photo shadows and adding yellow to the highlights, since taking down blue is the same as adding yellow. Then we'll check to see how the curve's adjustment is affecting our photo. If you think the effect is too strong or weak, feel free to continue modifying the curve spline. Next, we're going to apply a vignette to our photo. To do this, select the background image from the Layer Studio. Then come to the Filter Studio and scroll all the way down to the bottom to apply a vignette filter. When making a vignette, I like to bring the exposure slider all the way down. This lets me easily see where my vignette is being applied. Then I can modify the other sliders to whatever I think looks good. Then we can bring the exposure to something less extreme. To apply the vignette as a live filter, press on the lightning bolt icon and then press yes. This makes it so our vignette will be editable at any point in the future. If we come to the Layer Studio, we could turn the vignette on or off whenever we want. And even if we start working on something else, we can always double tap on its layer icon to edit its settings in the context toolbar. Finally, to see a before and after of our work, I'm going to duplicate the background image from the commands menu and then delete the vignette filter that came with it. Then I can move the image layer to the top of the layer stack. Here's what we started with, and here it is with our adjustments applied. Thanks for watching, my friends, and I'll see you in the next Affinity Revolution tutorial.